Hi everyone, welcome to Asiana Post. We have a wonderful guest today. Could you describe and tell us about yourself here in the community?
Yeah, so my name's Giselle Chusan. I am a content creator. I do food and I'm trying to do travel as well right now, but mainly food. I like bringing light to restaurants and just small local places in South Florida right now that are, you know, struggling with business or just to get their name out more. We're really used to going to big chain restaurants, and we sometimes forget that there's mom and pop shops that have amazing food. And you know, it's just cool.
So let's go rewind back real quick. How did you get into that? What made you become a food blogger or being a content creator?
So originally I actually wanted to do travel. This was like maybe over 10 years ago. I bought my first GoPro and I'm like, yo, I want to film everything I do. And I've been to 23 countries. So that's where like the drive for that started. But I never had the courage to post that on the internet. And then COVID happened and I just started posting on TikTok because people were posting on it. And I'm like, oh, this is a cool little platform. And I started out with like travel tips, like what to do if you like go to Amsterdam or blah, 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 stuff like that. And that wasn't really hitting. And then just one day randomly, I went to the South Florida Fair and they were doing a drive-through Fair Eats. And I told my mom, I'm like, we should go. You know, I love corn on the cob. I love fair lemonade. This would be really cool to kind of just like share to the community. And I did that and I got 500,000 views and it just went from there. I'm like, you know what? Let me do food. Like TikTok in a way is like a news outlet and this would be amazing for people to know what's going on in their community. So I did that and then I went to another restaurant that like, you know, we would always go to, and then that just kind of started like escalating a little bit more and it became like, I guess, a community that I have now with people.
Right. So do you see that there's more local communities or there's broad community because you're on the TikTok platform?
So actually, I find that a lot of my demographic is in South Florida. I have New York stuff as well, like New York followers. And that's because I've posted stuff in New York. But I have seen in my analytics that like my videos even get to like India, Colombia, stuff like that. So it's spread out. But the main like bulk of people are from Florida.
Very cool. Very cool. And so do people or company approaches you when you're doing these food or restaurant events and things like that, or do you handpick them?
So in the beginning, it was all just me going to places and kind of being like, hey, like, can I do a video? I was starting out, so I didn't really know what I was doing. And eventually, once I saw that this could be a business and I can start something with it, I just started reaching out to more places. Places that seemed really cool and I'm like, this would be really good content to post. And now I think maybe 80% of it is me reaching out. No, not 80%, sorry, other way around. 80% is brands and restaurants reaching out to me and 20% is me also reaching out to people. So I do get selective. I was telling my mom the other day, I never thought that I would get to the point where I would be rejecting brand deals, but it's crazy. Like it gives me chills to say that I'm now rejecting brand deals just because I feel like that doesn't fit with my brand.
Right. There's a core value that you present, right?
Yeah.
in your brand to, mm-hmm. to move forward to it.
Yeah, because it would look really weird if I'm like promoting, I don't know, like some workout supplement. Like I don't like taking supplements, so right. I wouldn't feel natural. I want to make sure that what I'm showing everyone is me. Like I try to be as genuine as possible. Like if I'm, you know, I don't know. I just try to keep it as OG as I can.
Yeah, we saw you on our reels and things like that, and we said, wow, this person is amazing and doing
thank
a lot
you,
of good
you.
Things on the community, especially locally. That's
yeah,
pretty amazing. You mentioned to me in the past that you had some Asian in you.
Yes.
Yeah. Can you please touch on
yeah.
that?
Yeah. So I actually just did the ancestry. I think ancestry, that's what it's called, right?
Yeah.
I recently did that and I'm 35% Southern Chinese.
Wow.
So my mom is actually, her grandparents are from China that immigrated to Ecuador. So I'm Asian and Hispanic.
Very cool, mm-hmm. very cool.
And we've been to China. I have my jade bracelet on, you know, it's good luck, fortune and everything. So I've kept it on since I was like 15.
Oh, very
I've nice. Had multiple because one broke, but.
Very nice, very
yeah.
nice. Did you hear about that culture festival that was going on in South Florida? There was one in Homestead just this year.
No.
Oh, you should have been there. You probably
When
would
was
have.
that?
I believe it was a month ago, so it was
No, yeah,
pretty.
I feel like I don't hear about a lot of stuff. It's really weird. Like, I see things after they happen, and I'm like, how didn't I know this was going on?
Well, our job here is to bridge all the communities together. That's what we're trying to do as well, not just to showcase everyone, but
Yeah.
that's what we do in the community. So when you're going through your information of, say, for instance, you're going to a restaurant and things like that, can you tell us how you do you get when you get there, do you speak to the manager? What do you do? How do you build that relationship with them?
So in the beginning, I would just go. I always like to call ahead. So let's say maybe a year ago. I've been doing this for a little over a year and a half. So in the beginning, it was me just kind of like reaching out, calling, and being like, hey, my name's Giselle. I create content. Is it okay if I come into your restaurant and maybe make a video? When I get there, I can show you what it is because I don't like going somewhere and just like without permission recording something. I've had restaurants straight up tell me no. One, we're not interested and we don't want to be posted on social media. And I'm like, okay, that's totally fine. That is why I ask. But now it's now planned in ahead. So I've created, like, I have amazing relationships with a lot of restaurant owners now. I've been very blessed with that. Pretty much now they just contact me and it's like, hey, Giselle, can you come in this day? Or when can you come in? And I just go, and that's pretty much how it is.
Organic.
It's very organic, it's very quick. It's not like, tell me about you, do that. I kind of meet them when I'm there, you know? So I create that relationship when I'm there. We have each other's numbers. I'm constantly like, when I post a video of a new place, I'm constantly in communication with that owner and saying, hey, the video just hit 100K, or how's it going? Do you have any feedback? What can I do like on my end? Could I have made this better in any way? So I think that's how you keep that relationship with
Yeah,
people.
one of the things that I was actually amazed because I was looking at the our Instagram, and I think you were in Open District, and then they had the robot down here. They had that robot
Yes.
server. So
Yeah.
like, wow,
BellaBot.
yeah, it's a robot. Yeah, that's pretty cool that you capture that. So
Yeah, and it was really cool. So they own like a ton of restaurants. So I've
yeah.
been very fortunate to just work with two, not all of them yet, hopefully one day. But yeah, it's just it's kind of word of mouth too what I do. I think I was recommended to them. So recently I've actually been posting a lot of like Asian fusion restaurants, and I feel like the Asian community is very tight. You know,
Yes.
almost everyone knows someone,
Yep.
and I've just been very fortunate to be able to, you know, get recommended to other owners and be like, oh, you should let Gigi come in. Like, she does great work, blah, 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 and stuff like that. So,
So do you have a team behind you, or
my mom.
that your
It's
mom, no?
me and my mom.
Hey, mom.
My boyfriend comes with me a
Yeah.
lot. He tries, he works, so like he's not able to come to all the places. I also work full time, so it's kind of hard to like, you know, get our schedules to align, but my mom pretty much helps me record everything. So whenever you see me in a shot, that's either my mom or my boyfriend recording that.
Very cool,
But
very cool.
everything else, it's me.
Yeah, you guys do such a wonderful job. I thought you have like a whole production
Yeah,
team
no,
here.
we've it's a lot of
So.
time. If you were to look at my phone, it's the same shot like 10 times.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you guys got it packed down.
We do, yeah. It's not perfected, but it's improving as we go.
Awesome. Yeah, so we also notice in during as time goes on that there's a in the Asian community, there's half Asian and half other like Hispanic and
Yeah,
things like
mixed.
that. Yeah, so did how do you feel about that? That kind of do you like there's some of them don't have voices for that. So have you or your friends had to dealt with that kind of scenarios and things like that?
Do you mean like as in like who we identify as,
Yeah,
or?
even voices, yeah, I guess. Because sometimes when you go to the Asian community,
Yeah.
they say you're not too Asian enough or
Okay,
something.
I get what
Or
you're
if
saying.
you go to Spanish, oh, you're half
Yeah,
something, you're
like what
not.
are you?
Yeah,
Yeah.
exactly. So.
Yeah, it's kind of, I think that's what makes people probably feel a little bit more comfortable when they see me in front of the camera. It's like, oh wait, this girl isn't like, what is she? Like, I get that all the time. Like, what are you? Like, what's your ethnicity? Where are your parents from? So it's nice to be able to see that in social media because you get a lot of, you know, other just races and you don't see someone that you can identify with.
Right.
But yeah, I guess it has been kind of hard. I felt in the beginning, I felt kind of weird because I'm like, you know, I'm not like white. I don't have like blonde hair or anything. Like maybe people aren't going to like my content because that's what's blowing up at the moment.
Right.
But I have seen it. I feel like it's more interesting. People are like, oh, that's cool. Like that's different.
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty amazing. So mm-hmm. I think you're one of those that will give those people voices in the future.
I really hope so, because I haven't seen there is, you know, a mix of content creators, but right. I feel like a lot of people feel like they're not, it's good to be different. You right. know, people like different, and I feel like people want to just conform with what they see on social media. So I hope people start, like, you know, just doing what they want to do.
Absolutely. So tell me, how did you feel when you hit that 100K?
Oh my
so
God.
They told me about it, that you were 100K on TikTok and
yeah.
that time, so.
The 100K was like, it was so amazing. Yeah. I was looking at those numbers. Well, right. it got to the point, it's funny, because I was about to hit 100K and yeah. then I lost like 2,000 followers.
Yeah.
So it was just like numbers were moving.
Right.
And it took so long for me to hit it, but the minute that I did, I'm like, wow, this is such a big milestone. Like,
yeah, that's amazing.
I never thought, like, who would have thought?
Right, right.
Because it just started off like as, oh, let's show people like what's around, you know, West Palm Beach, and
right.
now it's Miami and everything, and people actually, like, I go out and people recognize me. Like,
yeah,
are you Gigi? Are you Foodies? Like, and I just find that it's amazing. It's a blessing, honestly.
Yeah. Did you have to do any promotion on it? Everything is organic.
Right? Everything is 100% organic.
That's,
yeah, and like
it's pretty cool.
It's yeah, and that's one thing people are like, oh, she probably buys her followers, and it's like, no, like I don't think there's a way to do that on TikTok. TikTok is super strict on bots and stuff like that.
Right.
I mean, maybe there's a way to do it, but I felt like I would be lying to people if I did that. Same thing with Instagram, like. The growth that has happened so quickly is because of the consistency and like the amount of love that I put into everything that I do.
Yeah, let's talk about consistency. When you say consistency, what is it? Is it every week, every month, every quarterly? What is it?
I feel like consistency depends on what your goal is at the moment.
Okay.
You know, so originally consistency for me when I first started was like a video once a week or every 2 weeks. Right. That was consistency for me because it was something new. Consistency for me now is every single day post something, even if it's a story, reel, Instagram, like static post, TikTok, something, so that you keep engaging with the community. Because the thing is, when you stop being consistent, that's when things kind of like, you just get out of the groove of things.
Right.
So consistency, I feel like that is the most, the biggest reason as to why I have the success that I have right now.
Very cool, very cool. So for beginners out there in that realm that you're in, would you recommend them to be on what kind of platform? Would be TikTok, Instagram, Facebook,
I would
Snapchat.
So I haven't touched Snapchat yet.
Yeah.
I post like 2 videos on it, but I'm like, I feel like I'm doing this completely wrong. There has to be like something behind it. I would recommend just video content.
Right.
That is the main thing right now. If you look at it, even Instagram has said it themselves, they're trying to move away from photos
right.
and it all just be video. If you go on YouTube, they have shorts now. So I would recommend start shooting videos, post them on TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube. Just reproduce all your content because you never know what would work for you.
Very cool, very cool. I'm jumping on another conversation
mm-hmm.
here. I know you were in that ice cream place. I forgot the name of it. Tag, we met the owner of that with Sandeep. Spike,
where
is it?
Oh, Spike Dirt Nitrogen.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So how was that? How do you like that place?
I thought it was really cool.
Yeah.
I've gotten a lot of mixed reviews. When I went, people were like messaging me and they're like, oh, was it actually good? And I'm like, I liked it.
Yeah.
And that's another thing that I think is really important with when you produce content is not everyone is gonna like what you post.
Right.
I thought it was good. I don't really like sweets.
Right.
So obviously didn't finish the whole thing. I tasted it and I'm like, oh, I like it.
Cool.
But it was a really cool concept. I mean, I've never seen anything like it, so it was just very different.
Awesome, awesome.
Mm-hmm.
So what's your future? What do you see on the horizon for you? I mean, I know you hit 100K and it's a big milestone for anyone, right?
Yeah.
What do you see yourself, I guess, moving forward? Are you recreating yourself? Are you, what do you think is in the horizon?
So I think I'm still trying to figure out like who Foodies with Gigi is, you know? Like it's only been a year and a half, like I said, and consistently it's been a year that I've been posting. I think my main goals and what I see in the future is just growth and creating a bigger community. I work a 9-to-5 still, so
right.
I don't see me leaving that anytime soon just right. because I like job security, and this is very, you either get brand deals or you don't. It's not like this month I'm gonna make X amount of money. So I think it's just creating, you know, right now it's having a community.
That's a very good point, because a lot of people, elderly or younger generation, they get lost and they think that they should just drop and just go straight being a content creator or an entrepreneur, but there's still, you have to pay the bills and you have to do these things, right?
Yeah, and I remember right before, or right when I started Foodies, I was super broke. Like, I just graduated college, I couldn't find a job, I was the first graduating class of COVID, so no one was hiring.
Yeah.
Yeah, no one was hiring. I was like, and I was actually pre-med, so I was on the medical school route. And then I was like, I'm not doing that, like, there's no way. And I felt what it was to not have job security, and I'd never want to feel that again.
Okay.
So I think, like you said, a lot of content creators, they like see the numbers and they're like, oh, like this is what I'm gonna do full time. Personally, I don't recommend that, because you literally never know.
Right, right.
Like, you might have like the fan base right now, but in 2 months it just like might not even be a thing.
That's true. So. That's true. Yeah. So what you said, you're doing traveling in the future, right?
Yes.
What made that into exist? How did you decide to do it?
So I was just very fortunate since a very young age to have the gift of traveling, because I feel like traveling is a gift and like not a lot of people can do it. So at a young age, when I saw that that was something that wasn't normal, I'm like, I want to share like what I have experienced with people. So now that I actually have a platform, I guess I want to do what I've always wanted to do, which is share a traveling experience. So that can be, you know, going to China and just showing like, oh, here's like a Buddha here, or this is what I ate when I went to China, like stuff like that, so that people can see that there's a bigger world out there. Like, this is nothing. Like, being in Florida is literally nothing.
Right.
So.
Yeah, there's more things to conquer.
There's so many things, and I feel like it just builds, you know, it builds character. You just get to experience things that you never knew was like out there. Like, I went to Egypt one time and smoked hookah in a market with an old man. Like, who would ever think that was a thing?
Right.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. When you're going through the content creator, things like that, what do you get nervous and things like that, or tell us the step by step when you're going through it?
So in the beginning, I would get kind of like shy to just be like in front of the camera. So in the beginning, I would always start off all my videos with like, what's up guys? That's how every video started.
Yeah.
And it was 0.9 seconds, so I would get in front of the restaurant and do a what's up guys. And I would still get kind of nervous, but now I'm like stuffing my face, like in the middle. Like, I always try to go when a restaurant isn't busy.
Right.
Just because I don't want like to, you know, take away from people's experience. Like, who's that girl like shoving her face with like 10 plates in front of her? So the content creation process now for me has just become very easy, because it's something that I do every single day. Like, I edit a video or photo every day, but pretty much I go in, shoot all my content, go home, edit everything. And I use an app called InShot, because I know a lot of people ask me, they're like, what do you use to edit? And I'm like, InShot. That's what I've been using for a couple months now.
Is it because it's more intuitive than Adobe?
Oh, Adobe's just so complicated. I'm gonna be completely,
that's true,
yeah.
That's true.
And I have the, what's it called? I have Rush and Premiere
Rush.
On my phone, but it like, the UI just isn't that good.
It's not
so
friendly.
It's not user friendly unless you're using a computer. And since I'm creating content for a phone application, I feel like just doing it on my phone gives me like the more realistic view of what it might look like when I post it.
Right.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. So Where do you do you have do you have some sort of an office moving forward that you're planning to, or you're just gonna keep doing this for now till you know,
Till something pops off.
yeah, like a sponsor or anything like that. So what do you
So right now, I mean, I just do everything from home. I literally do everything on my phone. Like 90, maybe 95% of my work is done on my phone. Calls, emails, editing, posting, everything. I don't see, I guess my room is my office, like my office room where I even like work my 9 to 5 because I work remote. So
Which is
yeah.
good,
Yeah,
right? It
it's
helps.
so good, yeah.
It helps you what you're doing.
It does, because
Yeah.
like say I'm on my lunch break, I can just edit stuff, or if I finish my work early, I can do like foodies.
Right.
But in the meantime, I don't see me having an office. I would love to like get more brand deals and maybe sponsorships, but I feel like I'm a little picky.
Okay.
And sometimes they want so much out of you and the compensation isn't enough. So
Right.
a lot of brands right now, bigger brands kind of understand what it is like that they're asking for from content creators,
Right.
but smaller businesses want you just to go in for free, do the work, and they'll give you food. So I think right now one of my goals is to kind of have these businesses understand that, like, you know, work is work,
Right.
and I'm not here for free food. I'm here to bring business into your restaurant or whatever it is.
Yeah, bring more traffic to them and assisting them when those times are needed, right? Tell me about organization. How organized are you when it comes to your
My mom just looked over and smiled. I'm getting better at it. I'm
what's
kind
better from 1 to 10?
5.
Okay.
So, okay, now, like before, I used to just book everything and keep it in my brain. I'm like, yeah, Tuesday we have to go here, Wednesday we have to go here, and that's it. Now I'm actually using like the calendars on my phone and booking it. That's the most organization I've done, to be
I didn't mean to
honest.
put you on the spot if I
Oh,
did.
no. And
Okay.
I mean, videos though, I do have content like already pre-made. And this was kind of recent. I think this started in January where I just started having a lot more deals. So I have like 10 videos right now that I can post. I haven't po I recently went to New York.
Yeah, how was that trip in New York?
Oh, it was so much fun. It was
All right.
actually for work. So I went for a seminar,
Cool.
and just like after the seminar, we were like
Just went
eating,
to
eating, eating. Yeah, it was like
restaurants after
two, three
restaurants.
spots a day. Yeah, one day we did 4 places.
Wow.
So it was nonstop. Yeah.
Were you like in Manhattan, Lower Manhattan,
Yeah, we
or?
stayed right by FIT.
Okay,
We're
yeah.
literally right next to FIT. So we pretty much just walked around, did a whole bunch of content, but I still have to edit all that stuff. I've literally edited 2 videos. I have like 10 more that I need to do.
Oh, really?
So yeah. But once that's done, like I'll bust those out, put them on my drafts, and then just.
So everything was just food, not travel at that time when you were doing that, right?
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, like I didn't see anything that I can be like, oh, you know, go to the Empire State, I guess. But we went to the Empire State and it was no visibility. I was thinking of maybe doing a video of just like, this is what it's like when there's
Yeah.
no visibility, but I don't know yet.
Yeah. You didn't take one of those tour bus?
The tour bus,
No, you didn't.
no, because
Okay.
since I was working, like,
Yeah.
I work from 8 to 5, so like from
Okay.
8 to 5, like I can't really do much unless it's lunch.
Yeah.
So,
Okay.
yeah.
Very cool.
But hopefully in the near future I can like do like a full travel thing.
Awesome. Yeah. So, where would the community, if they want to reach out to you, where they can get a hold of you? Because we always ask these questions, because they bombard us with these kind of questions every
Yeah,
day.
and I try my best to answer DMs.
Right.
It might not be like immediately,
Right.
but I will literally take time out of my day to sit down and respond to people.
Right.
Usually Instagram is the best way. Yeah, I would say DM me on Instagram, foodieswith.gg, and I will eventually get to you.
Awesome, awesome. Do you also make do you talk to the people on the feeds when they do the comment on
Yeah,
is how important is that important, or is this not important? Because
I think it's important. To me, it's important.
right, like
Because I hate going some like to a content creator and being like, oh my God, this is so cool, and it just being completely ignored. Like, okay, like we're both humans. Like, can you at least acknowledge, you know, that I'm, you know, just engaging with you?
Right.
So I try my best to respond to every comment, even the bad ones. just.
So speaking of bad ones, right? How does that? Because I know there's a big rise of mental health, you know, because of the
Yeah.
pandemic and things like that. How do you make sure that you don't go into the deeper end and don't get eat up with the negative comments? How do
Yeah.
you do that as you yourself?
So I've been very fortunate. A lot of people haven't been like really mean to me, and I feel like one thing that you should work on when you start content creating is to have confidence, because like you need to know who you are, because these comments can get to you. Mental health can be a huge thing. I feel like a lot of people right now have anxiety and depression. I fortunately like don't really feel like I have any of that, but you just kind of like need to take your time away from screen time. So when I first started posting, I just got.
When you say screen time, like what do you mean? Can you please elaborate? Because we
Yeah.
do have people here, like elderly, are
Screen
watching
time.
us.
So that's just putting your phone away and
Okay.
not opening up any apps, and maybe just, watching TV or cooking, doing something that doesn't require you to see what people are saying. In the beginning, I kind of got like a little carried away, not with the comments, it was just with like how much time I was on my phone. So when I saw numbers, as in like views, likes, and stuff like that, not performing how I did, like that really got to me. I got like just, I guess, more like upset than anything else. And I didn't like the vibe that I like had going on when that happened. So what I did was just not post for like 2 weeks, and just now I have the mentality like I know I'm creating good content. It's just not being spread out how I would like it to, and that's just, it is what it is. Negative comments too. A lot of people are trolls, which is a troll is someone that just goes on people's pages to purposely, I guess, harm. It's social media harm in a way. I actually had that happen to me yesterday, and they were really rude. But you just gotta kind of deal with it. I like responding just because it helps the algorithm. The algorithm doesn't know a bad comment, it just knows a comment. So it brings someone else again to the page, and it's re-engaging. So I kind of just got used to it.
So, how do you know so much about that? Like on these analytical part of the social media. Where did you learn this? I mean, this is not from school.
No, yeah, I've.
So, did you have like your friends and stuff like that?
No, so I actually like have no content creator friends like in the beginning. I recently have made like three, and I feel like at least in Florida, I have seen that a lot of them aren't friendly. They look at you as competition instead of a friend. So I haven't been able to network. So no one has really taught me much. It's all been through TikTok
Oh wow,
that I've
okay.
learned, and kind of just reading on like, engagement and stuff like that. So a lot of like I'm on the side of TikTok where it's like engagement and how to grow your audience. So that's how I learned all that stuff.
Oh okay, because I thought you were one of those Gary V followers and things like that.
No,
So
I kind of follow him,
yeah, he's
but
pretty cool.
yeah, no, he
Yeah.
has really good things to say.
Yeah, he does. 100% he does. So that's what I was asking. So
Yeah.
yeah, so is there what do you think your next what next video that you're gonna be posting soon do you have?
Next video. So today I actually already posted on Instagram. Tomorrow I'm thinking I really want to get more New York content out.
Okay, cool.
Like I said, I have like 10 videos that I need to edit, and I just want to get those out because I've noticed that I kind of like fall behind, and then it'll be like December of this year and I'm just posting my New York content that I did in March. So that's New York content is coming soon.
Okay,
Yeah.
cool. Do you have a YouTube account
I
as well, do
do.
you? Is it
Yeah.
longer in the YouTube account? Your videos are longer or what?
Yeah, so I don't have that many videos. I actually have a rhinoplasty video there, so like my experience,
What is that?
my nose job. So I got my nose done
Oh, I didn't
two
know.
years ago.
I
Yeah, I
didn't
got
know.
my nose done. I had a very ethnic nose is what they call it. So I like wanted to get it fixed. But I have that, like I have that vlog. I think I posted a vlog from when I went to Chicago, and then I have like 15 international snack videos. It's just me trying international snacks. I haven't been posting on it recently, but I have videos from last year, from when I went to Colombia and traveled, that literally this morning I woke up and I was like, I need to edit those and post it out. Like, it's been a year. But
Awesome. Yeah, so again, well, thank you so much for coming by.
yeah,
Really
thank you for having
appreciate
me.
your time. I know you're very busy and you're probably tired from your trip and things like that.
I'm used to it.
We do appreciate you, and we look forward to talking to you again and want to see
Yeah.
your progress and I know you're gonna be probably bigger and bigger and bigger next time we see you.
I
So
really hope so.
on those algorithms and on the TikTok views and things like that. So appreciate
Thank
you
you,
here
thank
in
you.
the
Yes, thank you
community.
for having me here. And like I said, if any of you guys have any questions, just reach out to me. I'll try my best to answer them.
Absolutely. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.